Nolan, go ahead.
Geef de gordel ook.
Okay, guard, congrats on the win, man. I'm sure this is a moment you've been envisioning for a little while during the layoffs since you lost the belt to begin with. How nice does it feel to finally be sitting up there again with that belt in front of you?
Feels good, feels good. Tough opponent. I underestimated him in the beginning, maybe. But he's in his prime. So beating him, I was more technically, that's why I beat him. But this is a guy who is in his prime. It's difficult to put away, you know. So, yeah, I'd rather have a finish, but he wouldn't go away. After first round, I knew this guy is going to stay for five.
Was that the fight you were kind of expecting out of him? He seemed like he was trying to counter you a lot, kind of tentative at times, but he landed his shots sometimes.
Yeah, maybe I could have gone a little bit more for takedowns, but I felt that this guy is determined, you know, he came to fight. So once I was seeing I was getting the upper hands in the rounds and I wasn't taking a lot of damage, I was scoring my points. So I cruised to the victory. You can always do better. Not very happy with the performance, but it's a win. I won all rounds against a prime welterweight champion.
When you say that you cruised, are you kind of like regretful that you did that? Did you wish that you did more?
No, because it's, he's tough. He's tough. He's difficult to finish. He hasn't been finished for a long, long time. So I felt I had to fight like this. It was necessary to get the win.
And he hit you with some good leg kicks there. How are your legs feeling after those?
Last round he hurt me. I wasn't showing, I think I would have gone limping if it would have gone a little bit longer. So, I knew five rounds. I stayed. I didn't show, and I kept fighting.
And I know this one just got over, but before the fight, you said John Salter would probably be the next test should you win. You still agree with that?
Yeah, he's the next guy. Definitely looking forward to that fight.
All right, we'll go to our virtual media here. Santiago, go ahead.
Gegard, Santiago here. Gefeliciteerd, maat. Wat een prachtige performance.
Ja, top. Dankjewel, vriend.
Gegard, we spoke to each other on Monday, and you told me that Lima was going to see the best Musashi possible. And it clearly showed tonight. You were sharp and mixed your game up perfectly with the takedowns. In the first round, you got Lima to the ground. How close were you in finishing the fight right there?
I think the first round was good to set how the fight would go. So I managed to put my game on him. He felt my power. He felt... So I could, because of the first round, I was able to do that the next four rounds. So I think it was important to get the takedown and do a little bit damage and set the tone of the fight. So that me going forward, me scoring. And so I think the first round was very important.
Now that you have the belt back, Gegard, I can imagine that you would love to make a title defense in Amsterdam. Is that a short-term goal of yours to bring Bellator to Holland with that fancy, shiny title that you just won?
Yeah, 100%. There were talk to go this year to Amsterdam, but of course with COVID, it didn't happen. So whenever the COVID is finished and they come, I'm very happy to do that.
Jay?
Thanks very much, Giger. Congrats on the win tonight. First of all, dominant fight. The leg kicks really seemed to pile up in that last round. So how's the leg feeling right now?
Yeah, now when I'm sitting, I don't feel like I can get up. So now it hurts like a motherfucker, but in the fight, yeah, you're adrenaline, you're fighting, but I feel it right now.
Definitely. And, Douglas was doing something tonight that's kind of become a way to distinguish yourself from the other greats and go to that next level in trying to win a second title. You've talked about, taking a run at the 205-pound title in Bellator at some point. Would it mean more to you to try and go up and get that second belt and hold both, or would you prefer to, have your run at middleweight and then separate them?
Well, first John Salter, and then we go for after that. The landscape of MMA, I have to see what's going to happen. I don't care that much about two belts. I just need to win my fights. But yeah, if they give me, why not? I take it.
Donna?
Gegard, you've beaten 11 world champions now. Where does Douglas Lima rank amongst those great fighters that you have beaten in your career?
top three, especially because he's in his prime. This guy is in his prime, 31, won the welterweight, beat the great welterweights. He's a champion for a reason, tournament champion. So beating him in his prime, yeah, you could say it's definitely up there in the top three of my victories.
Do you think right now, if you were to fight, obviously it's not a possible fight, you could beat Israel Adesanya?
Yeah, listen, everything, but it's not on my radar because he's in UFC. I'm with Bellator, so it's not going to happen anytime soon.
Lenny, your line is now live.
Sorry about that. How's it going, Gegard? How are you? Congrats on a good performance.
Thanks. Thank you.
So you regained the belt back tonight and you lost that against Rafael Lovato Jr. before he had to retire due to medical reasons. Would that have been the one you would like to run back before he retired?
Yeah, I lost before. I move on. Wish him the best. He's a nice guy, unfortunately for him, his career ended. I could have won that fight, so it was my fault. I was sleeping the fifth round and he got the victory. I could have, but I'm not losing sleep over it. I'll move on. That's fighting,
Yeah, your opponent tonight, Douglas Lima, was stepping up from 170 pounds, but he looked in great size. He looked like the same size as you physically in there. How did he feel inside the cage tonight?
I felt strong. He looked as a big welterweight. It was the same size as me, so there's no way people can say I beat a smaller guy. That was a full-size middleweight. So, he's in his prime. So I take a lot of pride in this victory because that's a guy beating him in his prime. And he's the champion. So it's a great win for me.
We have time for one or two more here. Kevin?
Hey, Musasi. Congratulations on the victory again. This is the second time you stopped a champion from weight class under you coming up to challenge for the your weight class's belt. Are you happy enough to say that, hey, this is a message to all the future welterweight champions, don't come up and challenge me for the belt when I'm in this division?
No, because listen, the guy was the same size as me. He had a whole year to gain weight, and so he didn't look small at all. You have Kevin Gastelum, you have Kevin Gastelum, Whitaker, who are welterweights and they're championship material. So it's weight doesn't make you a winner, 5 pounds. Maybe I got 2-3 pounds over him. That's not going to get me the win. I won because I was the more technical fighter.
Darren?
Congratulations on, can you hear me okay? Okay, great. Congratulations on tonight's great fight and all that. When you have a great victory like this, what do you usually do to celebrate? Is there a meal that's your go-to?
Well, at this moment, my leg hurts. So I'm going to walk with crutches, I think. So there's no celebration tonight. Maybe with my friends in the hotel room and not sleeping that much. So.
All right. Thank you for the time, Gegard. Congrats.
No problem. Thank you.